What is the situation?
OCP tells us to stand down till SWAT arrives. That's our situation.
Looks like I'm on my way out.
Not so fast, buddy. Who do you think is gonna clean up this place? I'm not letting you off that easily.
You sound just like my wife.
If that's the case, let's get you patched up. We wouldn't want to get on her bad side. Press here. Medic! There you are, partner.
Lewis?
The hell is going on up there?
Sorry, dude! The police want us to release the hostages! So no hard feelings!
Hey! You can't go in yet! We need to wait for the reinforcements!
Reinforcements have arrived.
I knew you'd say something like that.
I am detecting a short circuit. We need to isolate the cables.
I think I've got something just for that.
You are very resourceful.
Thanks, but I'd say it was a team effort. They're holding everyone in the studio. It's on the 30th floor.
So, our friends in blue finally decided to join our glamorous show. I'm afraid you're too late for my autograph.
Chopper's ready.
I've gotta go, but the party goes on. Guys, make sure you provide all our guests with a decent amount of amusement, so don't skimp on the nuke. See ya.
What a freaking psycho. We need to be quick before they kill anyone else. I know that look, Murphy. You saw something, didn't you?
We are here to enforce the law, Lewis. Let us stay focused.
Right. Just keep in mind that I'm here if you need me, partner.
Hey! No sudden moves, cop! I'm not dying here! Get me another one of those choppers, like the one that took Soot! You hear me?
You work so hard, honey. Why don't you take some leave? We all could use a little break from this reality, don't you think?
Wakey wakey! I'm talking to you, Shiny! Stand back from that door, or I'll shoot her! I swear to Nuke!
I don't know what I would do if I ever lost you.
You've got 3 seconds! Three!
Our family is the only thing I need to be happy.
Two! Are you f***ing deaf?
Promise me. Stay like this forever.
One! Last chance, weirdo!
I love you so much, Iris.
You okay there, Murphy?
What does it want? Get it away from me!
I am sorry.
Can't you see? It's unstable!
Ma'am, please, calm down. It's been a very tough evening, and I assure you that everyone wants to be back home with their families. Though for some of us, the night has just begun.
Back in line.
They're here. Good job, Murphy.
I think you're forgetting someone.
Officer Lewis, you were remarkable.
Soot ran off with his tail between his legs.
Would have been nice if we caught him, though.
All right, all right. Are you done with this circle jerk, huh? Good. We've got a problem.
The malfunction caught on camera provokes a question. Can we put our safety into the hands of a machine, especially one as unreliable as Robocop? We asked Max Becker, the head of security concepts at OCP.
Now quiet!
We would never put a defective product on the streets. That's not what we do.
We all saw it hesitate in a life and death situation. Why? Does it really know right from wrong?
Listen, I would trust this guy with my kids. I mean, if I had any. This was just an isolated glitch. Thank you.
Mr. Becker, I've got more questions.
I just want to snap her little neck. But she's got a point. This was not an isolated incident. It's a pattern. A pattern that the old man wants examined and fixed. Time to see what's hiding in that metal head of yours.
We know what's in Murphy's head. It's what's in yours that worries us.
Push me, and you might just find out.
No secret. The crime has been on the rise ever since what the media has named the new guy in town showed up in the city. The word on the street is that he wants to spend a lot of money in old Detroit, and that has made every gang in the city start advertising their services. We need to find him before things get out of control.
Where do we look?
Our best bet is to see if he made contact with the torch heads. Robo, I want you to start by checking the arcade downtown. It's become a high-activity area for punks.
Understood.
Everyone else, keep your eyes open. Any questions?
Any word on Briggs?
What happened to Briggs?
He's been missing since yesterday.
Officer Briggs remains missing. That's over 24 hours since he's been in contact with anyone here.
Are the two cases connected?
No reason to assume so. But if anyone finds Briggs' informant, we might learn something new. All right, now get out there!
Lewis?
I'm all right, Murphy.
Drop your weapon. You are under arrest.
I don't think you're reading this situation correctly.
Thanks for the ride, big guy. It's the new guy in town. Welcome to Detroit. I assume you've seen our little TV spot. Short and sweet. You know the first rule of show business and drug dealing, right? Leave them wanting more. That's a lighter you got there.
Murphy?
Something wrong, cop.
So, what are you doing here?
I am going to Highland Park.
Now, isn't that street vulture's turf?
That is where the lead took Briggs. It could be connected to Wendell.
Oh, man. That's exactly what Mr. Becker told me you shouldn't do. It's my duty to stop you. Is it even safe for you to go? I mean, think of yourself. You keep malfunctioning, right? What if something happens again?
Hey, Murphy, I found this on the back seat of your cruiser. It's for you.
I can't let you go. Is there some sort of a command for that? Robocop, off. Robocop, stay. Hey, all cops have to follow rules. Especially you. You're a cop and a machine, so you can't go. Your systems won't allow it. Right?
Wrong.
Robocop? Robocop? Don't do this to me. Not on my first day.
I will be the first.
I'm gonna get fired.
Oh, look at that. One of the cops was actually bothered to show up. No need, SWAT's got it covered.
What is the situation?
Vultures came up with the great idea of robbing the OCP bank. They've got hostages, and they claim there's a bomb. They must be crazy to think that OCP will just let them leave with their money.
Was there any sighting of Spike?
Not yet. But I'm sure they wouldn't pull such a stunt without their leader.
What is the plan?
Let me make this clear. It's SWAT's plan. You're no part of it.
Then you are going to need a new plan.
With this buggy brain of yours, you think you still remember how to put the heat on them scumbags?
I prefer to serve justice cold.
You have to excuse me for not getting up. I'm in a rather unfortunate state. You did exceptional work at the bank. I want you to know that I am deeply grateful for your service to OCP and the city of Detroit. See? I grew up in this very apartment, or what's left of it. It used to be a thriving neighborhood, nothing like what you see right now. I always dreamt of turning it into the most prosperous district in the city, a new heart of Detroit. Can you imagine? Or do you think it's just an old fool's pipe dream?
My purpose is to fight crime, not to make statements.
No, of course not. Delta City's construction is about to start. Finally, the old and frail will be replaced with the new and strong. Decay and death are terrible things. You lose everything you worked for your entire life. But I don't have to tell you what that's like. It really makes me wonder, has the time you spent in that armor been a burden to you?
The enhancements allow me to excel in fulfilling my duty.
Not only your actions, but your words confirm that you're an exemplary police officer. The real reason I've summoned you here is because I'm worried. I'm aware of your instability problems, and it's not a matter that we can overlook. That's why I've requested to have people look after you. Tell me, how are you finding your evaluations with Dr. Blanche?
I am happy to comply with any activity that improves effectiveness.
You're a good sport. I can imagine it's not a pleasant experience, but I can't express how much I'd like you to keep at it. I'm sure that becoming a liability is the last thing you'd want. Am I right?
That is correct.
Now we've reached an understanding. Tell me, is there anything I could do to put your mind at ease?
My fellow officers worry about OCP's intention regarding their work.
Really? I'll have a word with Becker. Perhaps some new equipment would boost their morale.
It would be appreciated.
I have to say, you brought a lot of hope into this old man's heart. Now, excuse me. I'm not supposed to exert myself too much. Doctor's orders. And you can't argue with them.
Alex Murphy, the one and the only. I'm here because you have something that belongs to me. You have my badge. Lewis gave it to me. Lewis is hurt because of you. Because you keep insisting that you're something that you're not. You think that you are a fusion of me in this metal armor, but you're not me. Not even a part of me. I'm dead, and I want to finally rest, but you won't let me. Your delusions keep tormenting me and my family. You need to let us go. I want my badge back. I have it, so I remember. Remember what? The lie? Lewis knows us. She would not lie. Give it to me. It's mine. But, Lewis, I want it back. This is my badge. Then I'll have to take it back myself.
It's a new age.
And you have to accept it. My robots are here to stay. Detroit will become the first city policed entirely by my machines. No brains, no glitching, total control.
So that's it? You just gonna replace us?
You've already been replaced, honey. Can't you see it?
What are you talking about? Murphy's one of us.
You're a little confused. That's Robocop you're talking about. Murphy's the guy who's legally dead.
That's it. We are going on strike.
We are cops. Cops do not go on strike.
That's the spirit, old timer. I have important people to meet, multi-million dollar contracts to sign. You know, the usual.
Well, that sucks.
We can't just sit here and do nothing.
You can do something. Your cruiser needs cleaning after your last shift. If you have a hard time finding something to do, come to me. That goes for the rest of you too. Murphy, briefing room, now.
OCP has always been the pioneer pushing the limits of what's been possible in security technology. Those efforts gave us Robocop and Robocop 2. That's right. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to present OCP's newest achievement, the UEDs, Urban Enforcement Droids. A reliable solution to crime with the push of a button. UEDs will be exclusively protecting the streets of Detroit, since the police left the citizens of our city to the mercy of the criminal element by going on a strike. But no need for alarm. UEDs are ready to patrol the city today. Today will be their first major test, the protection of the mayoral election rally. Now, let's open up the floor to the questions. I'm sure you're dying to hear more about my robots, yes?
I have a question for Robocop. In view of the police strike, do you think these new robots are actually capable of protecting the city?
The police did not strike. We were fired.
The police left because they felt threatened by the UEDs. And rightfully so, my machines are superior in every way. A presentation is in order to show that those are not just empty words.
I have another question for Robocop. It's about the candidates for mayoral elections.
Who cares? It can't even vote in the thing. It's just an OCP product.
There are a lot of people that value his opinion. Polls show that Robocop's words and actions have influenced ratings for both candidates several times already.
And where did I put it?
Is that normal?
Huh? It's just a prototype. No need to worry.
More will come.
What the hell are you talking about?
What was that?
All of you need to leave.
We packed everything, sir.
Splendid. Duty calls. But I'm leaving you with something to remember me by. Good night, Murphy. Oh, it's been exhilarating. Now it's time to take what's mine. The city of Detroit.
Nice. You're leaving us again?
Dad! Don't go. Please?
He's waking up. Oh no. What do we do?
Murphy, stay calm.
He's in so much pain.
So, Murphy, how you doing?
I am doing well, officer. So many familiar faces. Are we celebrating?
Wendell certainly is. He stole a ton of heavy-duty equipment from that military expo. What happens when he decides to use it?
He already has.
You've got some nerve coming in here.
With no police on the streets, every gang in the city is on the rampage. Detroit's on fire!
She's right! I've got a call that Windows goons hacked the election broadcast to send a message.
Citizens of Detroit, I'm sorry to inform you that help is not coming. You've been abandoned by the police, by your politicians, and by OCP. They all promised you a better life and tried to give you hope. And where did that lead you? Into the cesspool. I feel your frustration. I empathize with it, but let's not stop there. Let us do the only thing we can. Let's burn this filthy city to the ground. And from the ashes, let's rebuild something new. Something better.
It is me, Lewis. It has always been me.